and there are some of the points which we are going to discuss today. First of all, internet, surfing and security. So we will talk about what is surfing and what are the security features we have to care about when we are working on internet. First of all, we will know the term internet and its history, how it was developed. Basically, whenever we are connecting two or more computers to share the information, then that is known as your internet. And internet is created by connecting many of the networks, and then we can share the data. Now, how it was done, how it came into the mind of people that we need such type of technology. Basically, in 1969, there was a Department of Defense of USA which started working on this technology, and they developed a basic internet that was known as ARPANET. I think you all know what is ARPANET stands for. ARPANET is Advanced Research Project Agency Network. It was developed by that particular department for sharing the information of regarding their new technologies which was developed in that particular department. So it was started there. That was not for the common people. It was only used by the scientists and the government officials at that time. Slowly and slowly it grew bigger, and it was started using by universities and the education institutes. Then it came into the use of common man in 1990s, and then we started using internet. What are the advantages and disadvantages of internet? The major advantage is that we can share the information, we can send and receive the email messages, we can play online games, and we can do online shopping. That is e-commerce. E-commerce is basically done using internet. Whatever we are doing over internet, online shopping, online reservation, that is all part of internet. Now, whenever we are using something, the excessive use of that causes disadvantages. So, the major disadvantage is cybercrime. Cybercrime is the type of crime which is created by focusing computer as a target or using computer as a weapon. Second thing of the disadvantage of internet is that we are neglecting our relevant work and we are focusing more of our time on internet and do not prioritize our important works. So we have to also care about it. The physical connection between our relatives and friends, that is already missing just because of internet. So we have to focus on that also. So just use internet as required. The excessive use of it can cause the side effects also. You can have the illness also, mental illness, mental pressurize. So just use it as required. Now, what are the requirements when you are connecting to internet? So basically, you need initially a computer system or a digital device such as laptop, computer or a mobile phone. Second thing is modem. Modem is a device which is used for sending your data from your computer to internet, and when you receive some data from internet to your computer, then modem helps in that. Third device which we are using is our internet connection. Now the connection can be a dial-up connection or a broadband connection. Fourth thing we require is internet service provider companies. You all know that we are using the companies like Airtel, BSNL, Jio. These all are your ISPs which provide you internet connections. So basically we require an ISP also. So these are the basic requirements which we have to use for internet. Now whenever we are surfing over internet, there are some terms which we go through. First is search engine. What is basically a search engine? Search engine is just a program, or you can say it's just a software which we require to search through a collection of web pages for a particular information. Whenever you enter any keyword, means you have to enter something in your Google page, that is your keyword, and you will get a list of pages accordingly. So, the hits which you will get on that particular page, program called the spider. A spider is also a program which is used by search engine to generate the web pages required by you. Okay? Second thing which we come across is web browser. Web browser is also a program which is used to search through the web pages, and these are also softwares developed by different companies. For example, Google Chrome, that was developed by Google. The first graphical web browser which was developed is Mosaic. Then the third term which we come across is URL. URL is the unique address which we enter into our web browser to search any particular web page. URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. Uniform Resource Locator identifies the unique address of your web page over internet, and you can enter it directly to go to the particular website, or directly for going to that particular page, you can enter the URL. Now, what are the practices for online safety? As I have told that whenever we are using internet, then there are some side effects also. So, what are the things we have to care about whenever we are using internet? First thing is, never share your password with any of your friends or your relatives. Okay? Why? Because any unknown person can misuse that. Your confidential information can be also used, can also be misused. Second thing, you have to not share your personal photos, videos, and your personal data over the internet. Social networking. The third thing is social networking. That should not be done in excessive use. Why? Because there can be inappropriate content which could be available over the internet. So you should be careful for that also. So what are your responsibilities whenever you are using internet? Now there is a term, digital citizen. Whenever we are computer and internet, then we are a digital citizen, because we are using the information which is provided by internet using any digital device. That is why we are a digital citizen. So what are our responsibilities towards internet when we are using it, so that we can have the particular safety which we want? Okay, so we were talking about the responsibilities of a digital citizen. The first responsibility is, whenever you are using your computer in your public places, then you should always log out your particular website. Second thing, never share your password with any of your friends or relatives. Third thing, share your information, or whenever you are using your computer in public place, sharing the data, then use the incognito mode, that is also known as your private browsing. Fourth thing, you should never share your personal videos and photos over social networking websites. And last and all, always use internet as required. Never use it in excessive use, because that could also harm your health, and it could also affect your mental ability to think. So use it as required, appropriately. Okay, so I think this is clear to you, that what is internet and how you